The new 8 o'clock on CNN. Parker Spitzer, weeknights on CNN.
When I say that conservatives like Governor Allen, myself, will have a great time election night, and maybe we'll sleep in morning of after the election, have breakfast in bed, read the papers, watch a little TV. But then the afternoon, we start for the battle for the heart and soul of the Republican Party.
Let's drill down on that for a moment. John Boehner, who is, if you are correct and you win, and Governor, you have predicted this as well, if he becomes the Speaker of the House of Representatives, he has said he would compromise on the tax cuts. He said not many weeks ago that he would concede the middle class tax cut extension and pass a tax increase on the wealthy. Would you go for that?
Absolutely not. And he's back from that 100%. And there's no way that the Republicans in Congress, in this new Congress, are going to allow that.
Governor, would you think this could happen as part of a compromise after the election?
Absolutely not. I think the very first thing they need to do is prevent tax increases. And the tax cuts we passed in 2001 and in 2003, which reduced taxes on income for families, small business owners, reduced taxes on capital gains and dividends, they need to stay in place. That would be the very worst thing that the government could do, is raise taxes on our economy and would hurt jobs. The second thing I think they need to do is repeal and replace Obamacare with health savings accounts. They need to stop the spending. And the fourth thing is take responsibility for energy policy and withdraw from EPA the power to regulate CO2, which would cause skyrocketing electricity, fuel and food prices, and be a job killer as well.
Governor, I want to ask you a quick question. Mr. Viguerie has said that everybody's buddies until November 2nd, till after the elections, and then he's going to declare war on those Republicans who aren't quite ideological enough. There's going to be a purge, in other words. Are you on board with that purge?
Kathleen. I never said any purge. Nobody said
purge. Well, I said purge, but that's what we're talking about.
Kathleen, I know you're trying to stir things up.
No, I'm just trying to get to the bottom of it.
Here's what I'm going to be focused on, and I think Richard will, and I think more importantly, not just us four, but all Americans are going to want to see the Republicans in control and keeping their words, keeping their commitment to the American people, whether it's on preventing tax increases, rational energy policy, stopping this out-of-control spending. And the people clearly want to see a repeal of this Obamacare. And I think it's very important that we have a positive, constructive agenda to get America moving and ascending in the right direction. And that's what I think we're going to be focused on. And we're going to have a lot of good new blood in Washington. Some have been there before, like Senator Coates, and there'll be other new ones like Marco Rubio from Florida. And I think it's going to be an exciting time to get our country back in the right direction.
Let me just say that to add on to what Governor Allen said, you've got an administration, Kathleen and Elliot, that's moving significantly to the left. You've got a country that's moving significantly to the right. To paraphrase Mr. Lincoln, this House cannot stand divided, and we have a divided country right now, and something's got to give, and the American people are tired of big government. They want less government involvement in their life, and we're off to a big battle in this country.
Well, I just want to come back to some numbers here, because Governor Allen, I think when you were in the Senate, during the tenure of President Bush, he left us with the biggest deficits until that moment in history. There was absolutely no control of spending. You were part of that. Did you vote for his budgets?
I did.
And isn't that why Mr. Viguerie here has gone right at you and said you're the problem? You're mouthing nice Tea Party words now. You voted for the biggest deficits in history until that moment in time, didn't you?
Well, those deficits pale compared to what we see now.
No. I'm going to hold your feet to the fire.
Fine.
You're trying to remake yourself as
Tea Party
member.
You
voted
Elliot,
for the single largest deficits in history. Did you not?
I voted for those appropriations bills, and I also, if you want to get the full record there, Mr. Spitzer, is I tried to stop some of the spending.
But you voted for it.
Well, you have amendments to bills. I even put in a bill to stop this spending. It was actually called that, Stop Overspending. And there were a few of us, about a dozen, who tried to stop the Republicans spending on the Bridge to Nowhere and for orchid gardens in Pittsburgh and indoor tropical rainforests in Iowa, and there's a lot of things that I tried to do. Unfortunately, there was only about 13 of us who stuck together with it.
Right, but I want to come back to
who believes that we do need to have a government that is focused on its primary responsibilities, which are national defense, and not meddling in a variety of other things that are really to be left to the people in the states.
But the point I'm making is the reason that Richard Viguerie, and we quoted the words, said you were the reason the Tea Party was upset, is you voted for the largest deficits in history when you were in the Senate.
Yeah, Elliot, and a lot of it. Look, Elliot.
You know, we're talking facts here. We're talking facts on this show.
Lessons
not
learned.
Not pablum.
Well,
and we're going to hold your feet to the fire on facts.
Here's a slightly different question. Can the Tea Party and the Republican Establishment Party coexist?
Well, no. I mean, this is the House divided. The Republicans lost the Congress in 06. They lost the White House and more congressional seats in 08, having, in my opinion, and most all Tea Party members, nothing to do with Nancy Pelosi, Harry Reid, Barack Obama. Had everything to do with George Bush, Karl Rove, and the big government Republicans in Washington, D.C. And you're making too much of a fight between Governor Allen and myself. It was the leadership coming out of the White House and leadership of Obama,
Richard, we quoted, you wrote the article, you put his name in it, you said he was responsible, his outrageous spending, you said his inability to control spending created the Tea Party. Now you're trying to play nice a week before the election, that's politics. We're trying to deal facts here. He voted for the largest deficit in history, that's a fact.